Hi everyone, merhaba, this is Ayşenur Altan. Welcome to Turkish Food and Travel. In this episode, we are making one of the traditional dishes in Kastamonu, banduma. It's a well-known authentic dish made from yufka sheets, turkey or chicken meat, walnuts and butter sauce. I'm making this dish for you in my mom's house in Kastamonu, Devrekhani. But I also went to the Kastamonu city center to see how it is made in a restaurant. So let's get started. First, I bought this special yufka for making banduma, which is only a bit thicker and it is cooked for more time, as you can see. What you can use for it is to bake the regular yufka a bit more on the pan, or I think thin tortilla sheets can also be used for it. Of course, if you are already rolling a piece of dough to make yufka, you can do that too easily by having a dough with flour, salt and water. For the recipe, I'm gonna also use turkey leg. You can use chicken too, but traditionally in Kastamonu we use turkey. I'm just going to boil until it is very soft. To make it easier, I'm gonna use a pressure cooker. I continued to the recipe the next day because we were very busy having a trip in Kastamonu, as you can see from the vlogs I shared, and there are more to come. And so first thing I'm gonna do is now to cut my yufka sheets. First I'm gonna cut it in half. By the way, it is about 1 kilogram and 6 yufka sheets. I used 4 of it, which was about 600 grams. It was enough. And we're just going to fold it like so, not very thinly. It is how it is made traditionally. I would have folded a bit more smaller, but I just wanted to show you the traditional way. Next, I'm just gonna cut in about 2-3 centimeters thick pieces. I had a bit hard time choosing the right knife. They don't work that much. I'm just gonna continue to cut the slices until I finish all the yufka sheets. By the way, I think you can also use the thick filo sheets, the ready ones that are made. Just make sure, since they are a bit on the raw side, cook it on the pan to have a little bit color on them. Next, I'm cleaning the bone parts of my turkey leg and going to tear it in a small part, which we call didiklemek. So my first preparations are ready. I'm gonna begin to assemble now. I heated my turkey broth. It is important because we want to soak the yufka sheets, so it has to be hot, not boiling hot, a little less than that. And I have melted some butter. It is about 100 grams, I can say. More butter you will use, more taste you're gonna get, as always. And after that, on my round baking tray, I'm just going to soak the yufka sheets first to my turkey broth and place it next to each other. After my first layer is finished, I'm drizzling butter all over them and sprinkle coarsely chopped walnuts. This is another ingredient that makes the taste go upper level. So delicious. And the next layer will be, of course, turkey meat. Now I'm gonna continue to dip my yufka sheets to turkey broth and create the second layer. The name of the dish banduma comes from bandırmak, which means to dip. As you can see, we are dipping our yufka sheets, so they called it banduma. Between the layers, I used about 1/3 of the meat I have and 1/3 for the second layer, and added the rest of the meat on the center. Then I continue to dip my yufkas and place it to the sides. I drizzled more from the turkey stock after I placed everything. It was about half cup, but it could have been more, like maybe one cup more. Since I was making the recipe for the first time, I didn't want it to be mushy, soggy. So you can have it a bit more. And of course, drizzle more butter on top too. And of course, more walnuts. As for the cooking process, you can cook it on stovetop, the bottom part a bit, which to make the cooking process easier, quicker, I did that, and to show you. And here I also drizzled more turkey stock. And after it is browned a bit, you can understand from the smell. Just continue to cook the top part in the oven in a 200 Celsius degree preheated oven for about 15 minutes until you have some brown spots, some colors on top. And while our banduma is cooking, we wanted to give the bone of the turkey leg to our favorite dog in the neighbor. Tamam. After he got his meal, looks like he wanted to get a nice, shady, comfortable place to eat. Okay, in about 20 minutes, our banduma is ready with the yummy smell filling our house. My family, especially my daughter, is waiting to eat it eagerly. I drizzled more from the turkey stock over. You can always do that too. And before I'm gonna serve it, I want to take you to a restaurant in Kastamonu to see how they make it. Right now I'm in the Münire Sultan Sofrası. We're gonna see how the banduma is made. They are in the center of the city, very close to Nasrullah Mosque. And they are making traditional dishes of Kastamonu. The first one comes in mind is gözleme, et ekmeği. And I shared a recipe with a lovely auntie, Şadiye teyze, last year. You can watch from the links. It was one of my favorite episodes from Kastamonu. Gözleme or et ekmeği is also one of my favorite dish from my childhood. But this time we're gonna learn how they make banduma. Bugün Kastamonu'da Münire Sultan Sofrası'ndayız. Yavuz Bey ile beraber.
Hoş geldiniz efendim.
Teşekkürler. Kastamonu'nun yöresel yemeklerinden bandumaya yakından bakacağız ve tadacağız. And here in the Münire Sultan Sofrası, they make their own yufka sheets. The one I bought from Devrekani was also handmade at the end, but you can do it your own. And it is kind of similar, as you can see, they just cut it a bit longer, looks like the yufka sheets. They just dip it and place it like a heel. You can do it better if you are preparing it personally. And they just place the chicken meat or turkey meat on top of that. Of course, you drizzle a good amount of butter at the end. And it's ready.
Hindi eti var tabii, kolesterol düşüren. İşte yufkası var, onu biz kendimiz yapıyoruz. Yine ceviz var, yine o kolesterol dengeleyici.
Şey, malzemesi aslında hindi ama tavukla da yapılabilir.
Ama tavukla tabii yerli tavuk olursa evet, aynı tadı bulabilirsiniz.
Doğru,
yani.
Doğru.
Yağlı olması lazım şeyin. Herhalde hindi kullanıyoruz. Yani. Hiç ben daha tavuk kullanmadım ama.
Doğru, harika yani. Gösterim sunumu da çok güzel şu an bakır tabakta. Onun yanında bir de eşimiz var. Şekersiz olmasına rağmen çok güzel serinleten bir içecek.
Ekşi elma dediğimiz elmamız var. Bu ahşap tokmaklarla dövülüyor. 7-8 saat kaynıyor. Soğuduktan sonra suyu süzülüyor. Jöle kıvamında kat olarak kalıyor. İçinde katkı malzemesi olmadığı için 2 sene kendisini muhafaza edebiliyor. Sulandırdığın zaman buzdolabında dahi olsa 2 günde sirkeleşiyor. Bizim hastamanın yemeklerimiz genelde hamur türü olduğu için bunu biz hazmettirici olarak içiyoruz.
Çok güzel.
Hatta bunu diyabetli dahi içebiliyor yani. Şimdi bandıma tamam, ikram edeyim. Arkasından ekşisinden tamam, alırsanız.
Bakalım.
It was really tasty. The butter was more denser. I think I could have added more butter after it is baked. And a bit more walnuts, I think, when I compare it to mine. I also wanted to try one of their old dessert, which is su muhallebisi. It is kind of a pudding, but you bake it, you cook it without sugar, and after it is cooled down, you serve it with powdered sugar, and it makes a different taste in your mouth when you eat it like that. It was delicious too.
Şundan da bir yudum alayım bari kapatmadan, şey kapatmadan.
O da hazmettirici.
Gerçekten harika bir tadı var.
Evet.
Çok teşekkür ediyorum ağırladığınız için.
Sağ olun. Afiyet olsun. İyi günler,
sağ olun,
iyi çalışmalar
dilerim. Teşekkürler, sağ olun.
So my friends, you saw how it is made in restaurants in Kastamonu. And let's get back to my version at home in Devrekani at my mom's house. And serve it. I think both were delicious. Since I layered some of the meat between the yufka sheets, it was more lighter when you eat. Also, cooking in the oven gives a deeper taste. But my daughter thought the one she had in restaurant is lighter. So I hope you give it a try. And let me know, please share your comments with me if you have similar recipes in your culture, or which product you can use for yufka. I'm sure you will have some ideas for that too. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more vlogs from Kastamonu and more recipes, of course. I hope to see you in another delicious Turkish food recipes and travel vlogs. Afiyet olsun.